choices because of that, but then post-assessment can be graded if it's what you choose to do, which probably will. So as a PLC, what they ask is to you use a rubric to create, the rubric that's already there, to create an answer key given the examples from each level. So they're asking you to take the post-assessment yourself and coming up with the answer key, basically. And then send any supports you have to Amy. She will then compile and norm it and create an answer key that's sent back to you, that's from you, in a sense. You don't really need to like really worry about this right now, because it's not going to be happening day one. And I see you look at like that, and Sarah, I did not choose this, so don't.
Assessment is like the middle of October. Yeah. We have one thing that our PLC meeting is dictated.
So you should give that feedback to the powers that be.
You know.
I do. So I'm just the messenger on this guy. So that's something that just that's coming. So keep that in mind. Next, you have an index card that should have been passed out to you. We're going to ask that you do two things at the end of the index card. First, on the front of the index card, that's not the line side. That's the blank side with no lines. On the front of the index card, if you could just spend some time giving us feedback on what was helpful during today's rollout. We're going to give you an option to also give feedback on the opposite side. What was helpful for today's rollout, and what's one thing that you figured out during your planning time? And we're going to quickly share this out. Okay? Does that make sense? Then on the other side, if you finish early, what your feedback, basically. Suggestions, questions, that's on the live side.
One of the things that, did you do your part in that stuff?
that's done.
Writing, volunteer to share out.
So you can kind of write this at the same time.
Oh, this is good. So I feel like looking at the pre- and post-assessment is helpful for backwards planning. So I enjoyed that. And then being able to pair and look at the skills for planning purposes.
Great, thank you. Who else would like to share out? They figured out, slash did. I'm looking at you, Eric.
Just something that we figured out, just looking, being able to look at that pretest and really trying to identify, we're able to identify maybe the struggles that we have, the questions mm-hmm. that we have,
yeah.
And then, okay, so what is our plan then for teaching that? Because if
yeah.
we have those struggles, then...
Yeah, I took it part of it last night, and I had some struggles with it, so I can only imagine how kids would, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's something to think about, is like, how do we help kids to, like, figure out how to definitively problem solve, something like this, and then also it's great feedback to the test itself. Awesome. Who else would like to share?
Yeah, so we kind of discussed in our planning time, we broke down the reading process even further, close reading process, and how do they need to know how to annotate for each of these pieces of the process, and we came up with kind of sub-classes for each one, how they would annotate specifically the process for annotating.
Did you write that down?
Yes.
I'd love to see it.
Yeah, well, actually we're going to take it up. We can.
Okay, great. Right, please do. That's awesome. Nice. So you're kind of working within that continuum that we worked on before. Mm-hmm. Right. Who else would like to share out? How about the people that were outside? Were you working
right
there?
Yeah.
What did you guys take on?
Well, we started looking at just with the beginning of the year and kind of what we needed to get in place at the beginning of the year, the time in. You know, how do we include the Greek and Latin roots tied into also what we were doing with the program with this unit? One of the things that we were really trying to figure out is kind of one of the questions we had early on was how do we get annotations, you know, making sure the kids understand how to tie in with this unit. So that's really kind of what we were focusing on when we think about during our planning time. Ways to implement that in while still making sure that we could get everything we wanted to in those 6 weeks.
Yeah, right. We can be tight, such as being in the year, and lots of other things going on.
Right.
I have a digital citizenship and I have written in the problem book.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but I'm kind of trying to be in 7th and 8th, but I just came back from 8th and 1 of our bids to make sure that.
You might have to talk louder.
Oh, the parking lot. Something I had, but just really as we started to dive into finding this, we pushed back on that today for the assessment. It just doesn't seem realistic at all to try and give a post-assessment during that, I think, October, whatever it was.
How was
it? So Amy said that's flexible.
Oh, okay, great.
So, I'm just thinking about
so I'm hoping that message will be like, there'll be some common understanding of that at the curriculum leaders meeting that can come down to the rest of the group. Because I think that's really important to have some consistency in that, right?
Just out of curiosity, what was the rationale for the day? Was it to give time to look at the post-assessment and then come up with the anchor sets?
Yeah, I think there was lots of rationale, to be honest. I think it's also giving pacing, right? And then also helping knowing that that's something that's done so we can all have something to look at the same time.
Almost saying you have to need to get the gas pacing, you need to see that for 6 years.
Yeah, so
I mean, it's next year, but I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah, I was involved in that process, so I'm not very
no,
sure.
Yeah.
What else?
Yeah, go ahead. I think it was really helpful to do the pre-assessment because I think it, for me, informed the minimum task that I was going to need to prepare my students for to be successful in the post-assessment. Whereas before, it's like this vague category. And it wasn't quite as vague as I thought.
So yes.
It was demystifying.
So yeah, no, that's great. Yeah, a lot of this work we're already all doing is just trying to figure out how to be on the same page for equitable experiences for all kids in your district, for sure. So we talked a little bit about the post-assessment, and we'll talk about that more. But I think for now, I want to make sure that I honor your time, and give you plenty of time to do this. Clock hour questions came up. Do you have an answer?
Yeah, so someone didn't get her the sheets that she needed, so she's going to take all of the sign-in sheets and make sure that she gets those right away. But it's going to be up to you, unfortunately.